Our next speaker is a business developer manager for Tape Storage at IBM, and with 21 years of experience in providing technical and sales support for data protection and data retention. Please welcome Josef Weingand with his talk about the future of tape. Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you. My name is Josef or Sepp Weingand. Now you know I come from Bavaria. Bavaria is a small part of Germany. To be honest, my German is not better than my English because we have our own slang in Bavaria. I work for IBM since more than 20 years, and I'm doing tape storage also since more than 20 years. I'm responsible in the region DACH, which means the German region, Austria, Switzerland, and Germany. And I'm responsible for all tape storage solutions. And I'm supporting customers, I'm supporting IBM sales, I'm supporting a business partner of IBM for all questions about tape. I'm doing configuration, sizing for backup environments, but also for archive environments. But also I'm doing presentations like here. And in the afternoon, I'm going to another conference, which is also here in Cologne, the Spectrum Protect, which is also a backup software conference. I am doing the same speech in the afternoon, but with a different title here. Talking about tape, are you still using tape? Or who is not using tape? Oh, so many. What's wrong with you? I hope, or the question is, why you're not using tape anymore? Or haven't you ever thought about tape? My gain is now for the next 50 minutes to give you some information why tape is still needed for your backup environment, but also for your data center. Yeah? And currently we see more and more new customers moving now to tape, yeah? Because tape has a lot of advantages. If you want to get more information about tabs, I have a lot of social media information where you can follow me and you get always the newest information, the latest information about tabs. I also retweet some articles on the internet and so on. You find all my blogs here. Okay, tape. Tape is out since more than 60 years. In 1952, we started first with the first tape drive. Was a tape drive with 1.4 megabytes of capacity. 1.4 megabytes. Since then, more than 60 years, we are using tape because tape is always the cheapest storage technology. Do you agree? Tape is the cheapest one. You do not agree? It's depending. I also do not agree for my home office, yeah, where I have maybe just a few gigabytes or terabytes of data. Yeah, because for tape, you need to first buy a tape drive, maybe a tape library, and some cartridges. If you just have a few terabytes, then it does not make sense because of the cost perspective to use tape. Yeah. But if you want to have it secure, this is another topic. Yeah. Costs, if we're talking about hundreds of terabytes, petabytes, or even zettabytes, then there is no questions anymore that tape is the cheapest storage technology. Yeah. Performance might be also some points why customer using tape, or still using tape, or even more using tape. If you're doing a huge backup of a large database, with some hundred terabytes, if you want to dump a huge database like SAP HANA, which is an in-memory database, and if you have 10 terabytes, 50 terabytes, and if you want to backup it's very fast and cheap and a very fast way if it's doing directly to tape. Yeah, because tape, currently we have a streaming performance with one single tape drive of 600 megabytes per second. 600 megabytes per second with one tape drive. And you can even scale the tape drives. You can use 1, 2, 3, 4, and you get still linear improvements in the performance. But nowadays, the most important point why customers using and why you should consider to use tape in your backup environment is security. Why security? Because first of all, tape has a lot of technologies inside the tape drive. The tape has a much better bit error rate than any other storage technology. Yeah? The bit error rate of a tape is 1.20, which means you can write 1 petabyte of data to a tape drive before you get one single bit error. Compared to a disk drive, to a cheap disk drive, nearline SAS drive, you get a bit error rate on Fehler in this disk drive if you write or read 100 terabyte of a single disk drive, then you get one bit failure. In addition, tape is an offline media. You cannot delete it, you cannot change it. Why it's now important? Have you ever get a virus attack, a ransomware attack? If you have some Windows clients in your environment, then it might be true. If you're using Linux, it's not so true, but it could happen that some ransomware attacks hits you. And what happens if you have a disk backup environment and you get a ransomware, a virus attack? It's not only your online data, but also your backup data can be encrypted with this virus. Yeah? And it happens so many times. We will see this later on in the last few months. Yeah? And therefore, more and more customers now rethink about the storage technology and using some offline data, some offline storage technology, and tape is an offline technology. In the future, or new customers are now thinking about the roadmap of tape. Yeah? And therefore, one huge customer which just starting to use tape is Microsoft. Microsoft, the Azure cloud, is now heavily using tape because of the roadmap on the and the future. Yeah, we will see this in a few slides. So therefore, Microsoft is using tape because of the roadmap, the capacity, and the costs. So coming about why using tape for backup and why is tape most secure. First of all, why we are doing backup. Why we are doing backup? Because we are losing some data. Why we are losing data? It depends on the environment. You can have some human errors. I have a small company at home, my family, with 3 girls, so my wife and 2 girls. My wife is not so firm with computers and the technology, so if my wife lose some data, yeah, then you have 99% human errors. Yeah. It's not the technique. But you can get also some hardware errors, software errors, yeah, and if you're doing a disk backup only, like Google is doing. Google is doing a disk backup environment, but also using tape. And if you get a software update and a software corruption, which destroys your file systems, then your backup data can go on within some seconds. Yeah? Sabotage means also, if you are a storage administrator and you have access to your disk subsystems, you can easily delete or destroy all your data from your company within some seconds. Yeah? This is also the reason, if you're using disk only and no tape, the storage admin should get the highest salary in your company. Yeah? Because if you're not happy with your company, with your salary, and if you're going to a disk subsystem, doing some wrong commands, destroying the configuration, all data are lost. Yeah? Even the backup data, within some seconds. How long do you need to destroy your file systems? Some commands, zack, yeah. Everything is deleted. What also happens, some different failures, like it happens last year in the ING Bank in Romania. What happens here, there was a fire alarm. The data center was flooded with gas, and if you do this, then you need some alarms. And these alarms make a lot of noise, and because of the noise, it could happen that the HDT arms, the head, will moving a little bit because of the noise, and therefore you get some destroyed data on your HDT. Yeah? This is also the reason why you should never sing before a computer or a HDT. Yeah? Because if you sing the wrong song, it could happen that the arms are moving a little bit and you get destroyed data. Yeah? This happens at ING Bank in Romania, and the data center was down for more than 24 hours, yeah? Just because of the fire alarms. Yeah? This is also the point of our online data. Yeah? On tape, it couldn't happen. We'll see this later on, because we are doing a read-after-write verification. But nowadays, so in the last 12 months, more and more customers rethinking about using tape because of the ransomware attacks. Yeah? The German railways, it happens some months ago, if you go to the station and you saw this information on their display, then the German Bahn, the Deutsche Bahn, the German railways has to pay some money to get all the data back. Or they have some tape backups, yeah? Or depending on the backup. Yeah? And therefore, we see nowadays more and more information also on the internet, on storage technologies, papers, that many companies are now looking to our old technology, tape is 60 years old, to protect against new threats, like the ransomware. Yeah. Therefore, for your backup environment, of course, we are doing some kind of disk backup more and more, but your second day copy of your backup should go to offline media. Yeah, and this is tape is the best, is one of the offline media what you can use. Why is tape so secure? First of all, we are doing a read-after-write verification. No other storage technology, no disk, no flash systems doing a read-after-write verification. Yeah? All storage technology just writing the data, and everything hopes that the data, the bits are stored correctly. Only tape is doing a read-after-write, which means we write one bit or bytes, and then after that we are reading it. And if we cannot read it, then we are doing a rewrite. And you do not see any impacts, maybe just a performance impact, because we have to rewrite this byte again. But tape is the only storage technology which checks really if the data is written correctly. Second, we have two independent error correction codes. We are doing like a RAID 6 on the tape itself, which means we have a parity linear and one parity cross-tape itself, so two different error correction codes. And with these two different error correction codes, we are currently able to recover media failure, physical media failure of more than or of about 11 millimeters, which means if you have a tape and you cut out 11 millimeters of your tape and you cut it, glue it together, the tape drive can still read all the data. Yeah? 11 millimeters. Physical errors on your tape surface, we can recover it. This means we have now an error on bit error rate of 10 of the power 19. Nowadays we have 10 power of 20 C new tape drives that's coming out, which means we can write more than 1.1 zettabyte of data before you get one bit failure. Compared to a nearline SAS drive, for instance, you can just write 110 terabytes before you get one bit failure. Yeah? With 110 terabytes, of course, you're using RAID 5. Maybe RAID 5 does not work anymore, because if you have a RAID 5 arrays with 10 disks on it, with 10 terabytes each of them, and if you have a bit failure, then you have to do a recovery of the RAID array, which means you have to write, if you have 8 or 10 drives, you have to recover about 100 terabytes. But after 100 terabytes, you get a bit failure. Yeah? Therefore, RAID 5 does not work anymore with the huge disk drive, so 8, 10, or starting with 6 terabyte disk drives. RAID 5 does not work anymore because the RAID recovery reads so much data that you get the second bit failure. Yeah. Therefore, only RAID 6 might work, or what the future is, or more and more customers now using it, no RAID technology anymore, it's using a decoupled RAID, yeah, which means a lot of disk drives, 100,000 disk drives in one RAID array, and using some different kinds of error correction code like erasure coding, which split more data to different disk drives. Yeah. So RAID 5 does not work anymore, RAID 6 might work, but the future goes to decoupled RAID or to erasure coding. Tape is an offline media, which means you cannot delete the data on the media and you cannot change the data on a tape cartridge. Of course, you can overwritten a tape cartridge, yeah, but it takes some minutes, some hours, compared to a disk or a flash drive where you just delete any data on it in just a few seconds. So if you're doing some calculation in with nearline SAS drives compared to a tape drives, if you're backing up daily 50 terabytes, so it's a mid-size customer of IBM, storing 2.5 petabytes of data, and if you're doing disk-only backup with RAID 5 or RAID 6, then you get a data loss of one RAID array after 2.5 years. Because you are writing 50 terabytes per day to the disk drive, it's backup data, and the calculation is you get a data loss after 2.5 years. Compared, if you write the same data to a to a tape, you get a data loss after 62 years. Yeah, 60 more years data secure on tape versus disk drive, so it's a huge difference. And this is also the reason why all huge customers still using tape. Yeah. So a question, some clients here using tape, do you have lost already some data on a tape? One, it's very seldom. It's very seldom. Of course, if you destroy a tape cartridge, yeah, with a hammer or something like this, as any could happen. So. It's because the tape drive has some. You need to feed it. Sit. No. By the way, it happens with the IBM technology, then you get a free cartridge because we have a lifetime. We have a lifetime warranty on it. Yeah. But normally it should not happen. It happens if you get a power drop, yeah, and if you're writing with 600 megabytes per second to a tape cartridge, which means it's, we are writing with 10 meters per second. Yeah. So the speed is really high on a tape drive. And if you get a power drop and the tape drive stops immediately, then it could happen that the tape is destroyed. This was with some former tape technology, but starting with LTO5 or LTO6, we improved the power drops slowdowns so that it should not happen anymore with LTO6 and higher. Yeah. But you can try it if you use a bicycle. 10 meters per second is about 36 kilometers per hour, and you can try to hit a wall, yeah, which means stop immediately. Yeah. It hurts a little bit. And this might happen with the tape cartridge if you stop it immediately. So even Gartner now recognizes that most customers worldwide still using tape. Yeah. Gartner always looking in the future, and I have never seen any Gartner report. The Gartner is telling the audience that tape is still usable. Yeah. But now the latest Gartner report about backup from spring of 2017, so in this year, about 50% worldwide still using tape, or all Gartner customers using tape for backup. Yeah. And interesting is, so Gartner does not expect any change on it for the next 5 years. Why for the next 5 years? Because the Gartner reports always looking for the next 5 years. Yeah. So even Gartner is telling us that we are using tape for backup and there will be no change on it. There might be a change, so it could be that we improve this number, yeah, because of the security and the capacity. Yeah. I do not expect in the next 5 years that we get less customer to tape. It might be that we get more customer to tape, what we currently seeing. So one big customer like Google is using tape, and Google has also a blog. They had some years ago a software update on their systems, on their backup systems also, and they deleted because of this software update was wrong or was not correct. They deleted the file systems or destroyed the file systems, and they lost data of 100,000 mail accounts at Google. Yeah. And Google writes that they are using tape for backup, and it takes some time to restore, so it was about one day outage of Google. But they're using tape because tape are protected information from these unusual bugs. Yeah. If you have no problems, then of course you can use disk as a backup. Or if you have no problems, then you even do not need any backup. Yeah. But normally you get some problems. Someone is doing something wrong, software, hardware, human, and therefore you do not expect these failures, and therefore like Google using tape, and for Google, tape is the last line of defense. And this is a huge tape library. Unfortunately, this is not from IBM, this tape library. So the question is, why is Google not using IBM tape libraries? Because Google is not a German customer and I'm not responsible for Google. Looking at the current backup storage trends and what happens also in the future, what I see from IBM perspective with IBM backup customers, one trend is, of course, we are using more and more disk backup. Yeah? And this trend's going that all primary backup data are storing to disk because we are using here data deduplication, compression, and all this function. But the second copy of the primary data going to tape. Yeah? This is one trend what we are seeing, more and more data to disk backup, but the second copy of the data going to tape. And this could be on a different building of a different city, yeah, on a different location. Yeah? But what we also seeing is that we're using a kind of disk-to-disk-to-tape backup. But we are replacing the disk, because also the online disk are replacing by flash. Yeah. We are now also seeing the customer using flash staging devices in your backup environment. Yeah. Because flash is much faster, and if you want to store the data after that to tape, and here we have a high streaming system. Yeah, you need a lot of HDDs to get 600 megabytes per drive. Yeah, and then we have not one drive, we have 10 drives, for instance, 20. Yeah, so you need a high performance disk subsystem to get your tape drives in streaming mode. Yeah. Therefore, some customers now starting to use flash as a disk staging device in your backup environment. This makes sense if you want to store your backup data for just a few days on your staging device, and after that you migrate it to tape. Yeah. If you want to store it for a longer time, like in this example, then disk is cheaper, yeah, and you get also the performance out of the disk, maybe. Okay, this was the security and how we can use it on a backup environment, but now looking on a different aspect, the capacity and the future. What we have seen in the last 10 to 20 years, the disk capacities are increased year by year with about an increase of 40%, which means each year you get a new disk drive with 40% more capacity. Yeah? This was in the time from 2000 to about 2014, 2013. Since then, we are slowing down, or the industry is slowing down the increasing capacity of the disk drives. Yeah. But still, we have an increase in our data. Yeah. The data growth is still there, but we get a decrease in the capacity growth of the disk drives. Yeah. What is the problem of disk drives? There's a magnetic limit on the current technology. We cannot write the data smaller with the HDD head, or we cannot read it out. Yeah. If we write it smaller, we need a smaller head. With a smaller head, you get less energy on the disk surface, and therefore it might say that the bit is not stable anymore. Yeah. This is the magnetic limit. Therefore, the last disk drive which comes out was filled with helium. Helium has different kind of aerodynamics, and therefore you can add to a disk drive instead of 5 patterns up to 8 patterns. Yeah? And this was the 6 terabyte drive, the 8 terabyte, the 10 and the 12 terabyte drives. There was no increase in the areal density, which means we do not have more bits on a surface. We just add more surfaces or heads in one disk drive. Yeah? And this was because of replacing the air with helium. But this is now also slowing down, and the next big step would be the heat magnetic recording assistance. The industry is talking since about 5 to 8 years, and always we get the information, next year we get the first product out. Yeah? Maybe we're doing this for the next 5 years and waiting for the heat magnetic recording disk drives. It's also called the HAMR drives. What is the technology behind? If you heaten some magnetic areas, then it's easier to do the writing of the bits. Yeah? And the heating of the magnetic area is done with laser. Yeah, so which means in the disk drives, you have in the head not only the magnetic head, you get also one laser. Yeah? And this is very difficult to put one small laser on this head to heat your magnetic area where you want to change one bit. Yeah? The problem is if you put small laser on it, the lifetime of the laser is very shortened. Yeah? The first demonstration of a heat magnetic recording assistance was in 2013, I think, and the lifetime of this laser was just 10 milliseconds, which means was just one round of a disk drive. Yeah. But the industry is working to improve it, and nowadays, I think in the next maybe 2 or 3 years, we will get the first heat magnetic recording drive out. However, there will be a slowdown, even with heat magnetic recording assistance, a slowdown in the capacity improvements in the disk drives. Yeah. Next technology is the flash technology or NAND technology. Of course, we can still increase the capacity. There is a limit in the lithographics because if you make the transistor smaller, on the NAND technology, you get a much worse bit error rates. Currently, with the 20 or 18 or 16 nanometers lithographics progress, we have a bit error rate of about, you are writing 100 bits and you get one bit failure, yeah, on the current chip itself. Therefore, flash or NAND technology is only working if you have a good error correction code. Therefore, the industry is working on the 3D design. Intel and I think Samsung is now producing NAND chips with 128 layers on it, yeah, stacking it up. And therefore, we get still higher capacity out of the NAND and flash technology. However, the manufacturing costs or the capacity of the manufacturing is not large enough to fulfill all capacity requirements. Therefore, on the flash technology or NAND technology, we currently do not see any decrease in the cost per gigabytes. Yeah. And the third technology is the tape technology, very old technology, but we still can improve the capacity. Yeah? And we are doing this all second year. We have a research lab in Rüschlikon, close to Zurich. And the last demonstration was in August 2017, so just 1 month ago. And we could show a 300 terabyte cartridge. Yeah? Which means we have written 300 terabyte on one tape cartridge. Yeah? The same size of a LTO cartridge, we have written 300 terabytes. And of course, we have also read it. Yeah? So we can write and read it. 300 terabytes. 300 terabytes on one tape cartridge. We have not done this on a special room. It's just a normal office room. And this is the demonstration where we have done this 300 terabytes, so there's nothing new on it. If you look on a current tape drive, it's the same technology. Yeah? There's nothing special. We have improved the error correction code. We have improved the servo tracking, which means we need to follow on the tapes and so on. But however, it's the same technology what you're using on the LTO1, LTO2, LTO3. Yeah? And with this technology, we can improve the capacity up to 300 terabyte currently. Yeah? And this gives the audience, the customers, the information that we get out each second year a new tape cartridge or tape technology with increased capacity. And also important is we do not need higher manufacturing cost for this technology because it's the same technology. Yeah? And this means we get higher capacity on one tape cartridge with the same manufacturing cost, which means the price per gigabyte is still going down with tape. (clears throat) 330 terabyte on a tape cartridge is huge. Yeah? And no one does need it currently. Yeah? But if you're looking in the history, in 2006 we have done the same demonstration and we have done a demonstration with 8 terabytes in 2006. So 10 years ago, 6 terabytes. Each customer told us, I do not need 6 terabytes or 8 terabytes on a tape cartridge. Yeah? But in 2014, 8 years later, we get out a tape technology from IBM with 10 terabytes capacity. And no one asked or replied to us, I do not need it. Yeah? Everyone asked for it. Yeah? So on server 2017, 330 terabytes. Now you're telling me, I do not need it. But in 10 years, who will be here in 10 years again? Most of us. Most of us. This is this is a different. Yeah? If you're going to an IBM conference and they're asking, where is here in 10 years again? No one is here because all old people is there. Here, all young people, and we need to work at least to 70, 72, something like this. So even I need to work. In 2017, I will come back again with 300 terabyte tape cartridge. Yeah? And all of you will ask for it. I'm pretty sure. So from the roadmap perspective, the green line, the green dots are the products which coming out the last 20 years. And this is an increase in capacity per year of about 30% per year, which means every two or third years, every second or third years, we get out a new tape technology with at least doubled capacity. And we have proven this, or we have done this since more than 20 years. With the tape demonstration in the lab, we can now prove that we can increase the roadmap for the next 10 years and also double the tape capacity every second year or third year. Yeah? So we will do this in the future for the next 10 years, what we have already done the past 20 years. This is the reason why we are doing the demonstration in Rüschlikon. So, and what happens with the disk technology? And this is a slide from Hitachi, which telling us that we get just 15% increase in capacity, and with HAMR, we get about 25 to max 30%, but the industry thinks more about 20%. What does it mean? If you look at the data grow, the data grow is the yellow line, which is about 30 to 40% per year. The red line is the disk increase capacity. And if you're looking back in the history, in 2014, there was no difference in the data grow and in the capacity grow of the disk drives. And therefore, no one was thinking about to do something different. Because if you replace a disk drive, you get higher capacity and you can fulfill your data grow. Yeah? But nowadays, or in the future, there's a huge gap between the disk capacity grow and the data grow. And this is the reason why more and more customers are rethinking about storage technology and using some different technology to fill this gap, like Microsoft is doing it. Now coming to Microsoft, why Microsoft is now starting to use tape. Microsoft in the Azure cloud. Microsoft is using tape in the Azure cloud. They analyzed all storage technologies, and important for cloud services is the price per gigabyte. Yeah. Therefore, Microsoft has developed its own disk drive, a disk subsystem with erasure coding, MAT technology, which means they are slowing down disk drives or stopping disk drives it is not using, and so on. And this is for Microsoft the cheapest disk technology. And there is a price for Microsoft, including power, manpower, maintenance, and so on, price per gigabyte of 12 US cent. They have compared it also to the tape, and there was just 6 cent for tape. So there's a difference of two, a factor of two between disk and tape. So factor of two might be not much, but per gigabyte, but if you're thinking about zettabytes, then even this 6 cent could be huge if you're talking about zettabytes. So the important point is here, what do you thinking? Is the price between tape and disk going down? So decreasing or increasing? The industry thought in the last 20 years that the price between disk and tape is going down, which means the disk price is more going down than the tape price, and in the future, the price per gigabyte on the disk technology will hit the tape price per gigabyte. But this will be not true. Microsoft has analyzed all the data, and they figured out in 2020, price per gigabyte, the difference between disk and tape is a factor of 4. Yeah? Which means price between disk and tape is not decreasing, it's increasing. Yeah? And therefore, we should now rethink about our storage technology. And if someone is saying that tape is not cheaper than disk, then this might be true 10 years ago or the last 5 years ago, but this will be not true in the future. Yeah? Why is the reason? Because we do not get higher capacity on the disk drives, not much higher. And if we get higher capacity on the disk drives, the manufacturing costs for the disk drives is getting it's costly more. Yeah? Compared to the tape, which still can increase the capacity. Currently, we have proven 300 terabytes with the same technology, which means also the manufacturing cost might be the same, but we get much higher capacity. Therefore, the price per gigabyte is still slowing down for the tape, and this will be not slowing down so much as we have known it for the disk drives. And this is the reason why Microsoft is now starting to use tape heavily. Yeah? And we have developed some special tape drives for Microsoft, or we are looking what they are needing, and we see a huge business for IBM for all the cloud providers, because on the cloud providers we are talking about zettabytes of data. Zettabytes of data needs to be managed, costly managed, and therefore on all cloud environments you will see more and more tape. Okay, Microsoft has develop its own file systems to do the migration from an online file to an offline to a tape. If you want to use some technology, get a file system with the integrated move to tape. You can use GPFS from IBM or Spectrum Scale, where you get a single namespace. And the file system is managing the tiering between different storage technology. You can use flash, you can use disk, and you can use tape. And your end user on the file system does not see any difference. It's the data on flash, disk, or on tape. The only difference might be if the data is stored on tape, you get an archive bit. And if you want to read the data, it takes some seconds more than to read it out from flash. Yeah? But for the application, for the end user, there is no difference in the access method. Yeah? Okay, the information from Microsoft, you can look it on UTAP, so that's all public, it's nothing secure on it. So up to here, this was technology and the look in the future. If you have some questions about tape technology. Then I will come now to tape products which you can buy or which you might buy in the next few weeks. Yeah. Therefore, you see here, because you are special clients, you see here also some confidential information. So you should keep it confidential until it's announced. Yeah. We will announce it soon, like LTO8. LTO8. 12 terabytes capacity, you will see it next month. This is what we have done in the last few months, and you also see that IBM is heavily investing in tape technology. We never had the possibility to get two different tape drives out in 1 year. We have done the enterprise tape drives special for Microsoft with 15 terabytes capacity, and now in, this was in May, and now in October we will get the 12 terabyte with LTO8. If you look at all technology or products from IBM, we have on one hand the LTO technology, LTO5, LTO6, LTO7, and in future, in few weeks, you get LTO8 with 300 megabytes per second, single stream performance, native, with compression. If you have compressible data, you can write up to 600-700 megabytes per second to one tape drive. And then we have the enterprise technology for customers using huge capacities. So we are talking about some petabytes, 5 petabytes, 10 petabytes, and more. Then it makes sense to using the enterprise tape drives with much higher capacity, like here with the current tape drive with 15 terabyte capacity. Native capacity, all tape drives doing compression. If the data are compressible, then you can write up to 40 terabytes to one tape cartridge. Yeah. Of course, we need the tape cartridges, LTO cartridges, or the enterprise cartridges. The enterprise cartridge is slightly larger than the LTO cartridge. it's a little bit different, it's a little bit larger. This is because of the history. So it was 20 years ago, the cartridge was still the same size. And then we started 15 years ago with LTO, and we tried to slow down the size of a tape cartridge. Most tape drives are installed in tape libraries. We have a small tape library with just nine slots and one tape drive. And we had in the past some smaller libraries with one or two tape drives, or up to 4 tape drives, and up to 44 slots. And then we have we had a scalable library, TS3310, with a scaling of 30 slots to 408 slots. We replaced those three libraries with just one library. This is the TS4300 tape library. It's a scalable library. We can start with one module, 1 to 3 tape drives, and up to 32 cartridges. And we can scale it with 6 additional expansion modules up to 270 slots and up to 21 tape drives. And then we have the high-end tape library for all cloud customers or cloud service provider for all enterprise customers. IBM is still using one of the enterprise tape libraries, which is also scalable, starting with 100 slots and going up to 23,000 cartridges. Yeah. And we have also some disk backup options, all disk drives, and we have also for mainframe some tape libraries. I want to show you the roadmap and also talking about the libraries. On the roadmap, on the time, you see all 2 or 3 years we get out a new tape technology, LTO5, LTO6. LTO7 was out in 2015. And now in October, we will get LTO8 with 12 terabytes. What we for LTO8, it's one-off, or normally on LTO, you can read 2 generations backwards, which means LTO7 can read LTO6 and LTO5 cartridges. Yeah. For LTO8, it will be a one-off that LTO8 can just read and write LTO7. But LTO8 will be not able to read LTO6. Yeah. But with LTO9, we will still going back 2 generations. Why is that important? Because many customers using one generation for some years and then moving to the next generation, and you want to have any data migration possibilities. Yeah. With LTO7, it was easy. If you had an LTO5, you buy an LTO7 tape drive, and you can steal your data on the LTO5 cartridges. Yeah. Now with LTO8, you need to rethink about your migration strategy. You need to keep some LTO7 or LTO6 tape drives to read the older cartridges like LTO6. The reason behind is, with LTO6, we still using the old tape material. It was a metal particle tape cartridges. And since LTO7, we are using the barium ferrite cartridge, which is the new cartridge for the future. And the old cartridge, we cannot use it on LTO8. Yeah. So this is important for all customers using LTO6 and want to go to LTO8. On the enterprise side, it makes sense for all huge customers. We have the 15 terabyte out, and next year we will get 20 terabytes with the next generation. So you see also here about each second or third year, we get a new generation out with capacity. See, big difference on the enterprise technologies, we can still use some tape cartridges from the older generation with higher capacity. This is not possible with LTO. In LTO, you always get one cartridge for this generation to get the higher capacity. Yeah. For the enterprise technology, you can use, for instance, the GD cartridge. 3 years ago, it was 10 terabytes, then you buy a new cartridge, a new tape drive, you can still use the same tape cartridge and can write 15 terabytes, yeah, on the same cartridge. Normally, on tapes, we're using either fiber channel or SAS technology, but now we are starting to use also Ethernet-based tape drives. Ethernet, either with the Rocky interface or with iSCSI. Why we are doing this? Because Microsoft or all huge cloud data centers does not use any more fiber channel. Everything is based Ethernet or IP-based, and therefore we are also moving in this area and get now tape drives with the Ethernet interface. What I also see is for huge universities or science customers, all those customers are using fiber channel only for the tape infrastructure. And they are now highly interested in the new tape drives with Ethernet. Also, we did an investment in a new head, the TMR head, the tunneling magnetic resistance head, was used for the HDD started this TMR head in 2014. Also here, we are seeing technology which was out in the HDD environments. 10 to 15 years ago are moving now to the tape technology. Yeah. So, which also means we are about 15 years behind of the HDDs. Yeah. And 15 years ago on the HDDs, we get always higher capacity. Yeah. Which also means on the tape drives, we are now moving for the next 15 years and can use the TMR head and get higher capacity. LTO 8 will be announced soon, in the next few weeks. Will be available for all IBM tape libraries. I have already talked about 12 terabytes. We will get the full high tape with 316 megabytes per second. Full high means the higher mounting hardware. And we get also half high tape drives, and this has a lower performance. It's about just 300 megabytes per second. The difference between full high and half high might be just the performance, not only the maximum performance, but also the recall performance. If you want to read some data out or need to read a lot of data out, the rewind speed, the access speed is on the full high tape drive much higher than on the half high. Yeah. But I think for most mid-range customers and for the slower mid-range tape libraries, more and more customers are using the half-high tape drives. Because we get more tape drives in one module. Yeah? And it might be also cheaper with the half-high. So the mid-range tape libraries, the TS4300 tape libraries, very interesting libraries because we can scale it from 32 slots up to 272 tape cartridges. We can install up to 21 LTO drives, LTO6, LTO7, and in the next few weeks also LTO8. We can have a fiber channel or the SAS connectivity. we get a web GUI to manage the library. We can library partitioning. It's free of charge. You can use it. Encryption is available with this library and so on. So information about the scaling. You can have a standalone module with up to 3 drives and 32 cartridges. And if you expand it, you need to install it in a 19 rack inch. This for a reference, if you need to scale or to size the environment. Last few foils will be the enterprise library. You can scale it up to 10 meters and 20,000 cartridges. It has a higher speed. You get a much higher web GUI usage with email notification and all this. More environments, functions. What also interesting is if you have an archive library, you get a media verification. If you have some cartridges which are not accept over the 3 years, for instance, you can do an automatic media verification, which means the library mounts the cartridge and reads the data out if the data are readable. The enterprise library are very interesting feature is the dual gripper. Dual gripper means, I need to go back. We have one robotic arm with two grippers. Yeah? With two grippers, which means you can have use the cartridge and two different grippers. Yeah? Why it's important? Because you can get higher performance. Yeah? And why you need higher performance? I recognize this here in Cologne. Yeah? In Bavaria, we have normally beers, 1 liter, one mass. Yeah? In Oktoberfest, you have a big stone, and there's a lot of beer on it. Yeah? Here in Cologne, you're always thirsty, yeah? Because the beer is just this size. It's you take it, and it's empty. Yeah? And therefore, what I recognize here in Cologne is the service is doing a kind of dual gripper, like this. You have an empty glass and you get a full glass. This is dual gripper. And I saw this yesterday evening and I found it so funny because this is how the tape library works. Thank you.